Have you ever been to the market and found a math legend selling vegetables? While you on the other end dreaming of top colleges still shuffle your pennies like a five-year-old? Don't worry, you're not alone. We all envy the super fast calculation of the great veggie man. Well, you don't have to feel underconfident and do your mental calculation the entire time in the market because I have something for you. In today's video, I will give you 5 super fast math tricks to help you do fast calculations in your exams. So without wasting our mathematical calories, let's get going. Hey everyone, this is Chetna and you're watching Chet Chat. And it's a Friday today. And many of you have asked me to do this video. So here we are and let's start with our first trick. Now, the first trick is for averages. Sometimes we get these kind of questions in our exams. We get these huge, big, numerous numbers and we're supposed to calculate the average. Now, I know that the simplest way to calculate the average, or at least the official way to calculate the averages, is to add up all these numbers and divide it by the number of numbers. How about I give you a shortcut? So here it goes. Take a look at these numbers and let's take a number that's somewhere we think in between these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 numbers, somewhere in between. So I think 900 could be somewhere in between. Now let's say I subtract 900 from each one of these. So if I do 878 minus 900, I will get minus 22. Then I do 894 minus 900, I will get minus 6. 922 minus 900, I get 22. 880 minus 900, I get minus 20. 912 will give me a plus 12. 900 will give me nothing. Here I get a plus 20 and then I get a plus 6. Now the trick is to add up all these numbers. How cool is that? Let's say, so these two cancel out. These two cancel out. These two cancel out. And what do I get? I get a plus 12. But wait, now, by the way, I've just chosen some numbers which ended up cancelling out. They may not, but what you have to do is you have to add up all of this and now divide this by 8 because there were 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 numbers. So what do I get? 1.5. Now, I had started with 900 and now I just have to, because this is a plus 1.5, I just have to add a 1.5 to it and your average is 901.5. Easy peasy, chocolate squeezy, isn't it? And before we go on to technique number two or trick number two, I want to give a shout out to Hema, who left this awesome message under our last video, which got so many likes from you. And if you want to get a shout out in my next video, leave me a comment below with the hashtag ChetChatters. Trick number two is to find the HCF of a large number of numbers. Now, typically you would do prime factorization and then look for the highest common factor. Let me show you a trick here. Let's say you have these three numbers. Now pick the two numbers that are nearest to each other. In our case, it is 430 and 516. Let's find the difference between them. How do you find the difference between them? The same way we did averages. Let's say I take 500, so I've got 70 and 16. So the difference between them is 86. That, by the way, was another shortcut to find differences between numbers. So now we have the difference between these two numbers is 86. How about we factorize this? When we factorize 86, we get 2 into 43. And if you pick the larger of the two factors, that will be your HCF of these three numbers. You want to try that out yourself? Yeah? Okay, now I'm going to give you much larger, more monstrous numbers and let's see how we do on that. Okay, here we go with 5 monstrously large numbers and you need to calculate the HCF of them. Let's use the trick that we just learned. Find the two nearest numbers. Here we have 4, 3, 7, 6, 8 and 43769. And what's the difference between them? The difference between them is 1. And the HCF of these numbers is 1 and cannot be any more than that. Easy peasy, wasn't it? Okay, trick number 3 is to find a square of a 2-digit number. Now, let's say we have the number 43. We need to find the square of it. Let's divide this into 3 parts. Okay? Now, we take this 4 and here we write 4 square. And we take this 3 and here we write 3 square. Now, the term in the middle is 2 into 4 into 3. Now, this should only be 1 digit. This should only be 1 digit and I'll explain how that happens. This is 1 digit right now. It is 9. Okay. This is 16. And this is 24. Now, to make this into 1 digit, what we'll do, we'll keep the 4 and we'll add the 2 to the 16. So this becomes 16 plus 2, it becomes 18. The 4 comes down and the 9 comes down. And what is the square of 43? 1849. Don't believe me? Let's try another one. Okay, so we have a bigger number and let's see if it works here as well. 67 square, dividing it into 3 different parts. Here we take 6 square, so we put 36. Here we take the 7 square and we put 49. Now what do we have in the middle? 2 into 6 into 7. Now remember I said this should be reduced to 1 digit. So we take the 9 and we take the 4 and first what do I get here? 6 into 7? 42 into 2? 84. So 84 and then I add the 4 here. Right? So I get 88. Now this also has to be 1 digit. So I take this 8 and I add it to the 36. You're getting the drift? So this becomes 8 and 6, 14, 44. So what do we get? We get 44 and we get an 8 from here and we get a 9 from here and the answer is 4489. Try it at home with any 2-digit number and this trick never fails. Okay, and now we have trick number 4, which is to find the square root of a perfect square. Before we do that, let me show you a pattern because we are going to use this pattern. So I want you to see this very carefully. I've written the squares of the first 10 numbers. Look at the digits in the units place. Notice, whenever you see a 1, it's either a square of a 1 or a 9. Okay? Wherever you see a 4, it's either the square of a 2 or an 8. Now, look at that. Whenever you see a 9, it's either the square of a 3 or a 7. And whenever you see a 6, similarly, it's either the square of a 4 or a 6. 5 is always the square of 5 and 0 is always the square of a 0. Now, once you notice this, we're going to pick up a perfect square number and see how we're going to use this and quickly find the square root. So here you go. You have a number 4489. The first thing you do is you break it up into 2 parts. Now, it's a 2-digit number. It's a 4-digit number. So it's easy for me to break it up into 44 and 89. But if it was more than 4 digits, keep 2 digits here and the balance here. Okay, now let's look at this 89. Now we know for a fact that if the units place is a 9, come on, leave a comment for me below and tell me if the units place is a 9, what could be the units place of the square root, which is going to give you the square having the units place as 9. Correct. You're right. So the units place could either be 3 or 7. The square root of 4489 could have a units place of either 3 or 7 because there is a 9 here, right? We saw that pattern. Now let's look at this number 44. 44 lies between which two perfect squares? 44 lies between 36 and 49, which is 6 square and 7 square. Lies between 6 square and 7 square. So what we need to do is we need to pick the lower of the two numbers. So let's pick 6. Now, by the way, let me tell you already that the answer to what is the square root of 4489 is either 63 or 67. Now, if you just understood this, what you can do is you can go back and do 63 square and 67 square and you can get the right answer. But let me show you another trick to find out which one of the two it is. Yes, there is a trick for that. Let's do 6 into 3, 18. 6 into 7, 42. Now we have to pick the larger of the two so long as it is smaller than 44. Very interesting. So we will pick 42. Between 6 threes are 18, 6 sevens are 42. Okay, between 18 and 42, we will pick the number that is larger provided it is smaller than 44. So we're going to pick 42, which means that the square root of 4489 is 67. Try that in your notebooks and let's try it with one more number. Okay, now we take another number, which is 1849. And can you quickly find out the square root of this number and leave a comment for me below using the trick that we just taught you? And let's practice it one more time. Dividing it into two parts, taking two digits on one side, 49, and taking the balance on this side. Okay, now we know, again, we have a 9 in the units place, which means that the units place of the square root will either be 3 or 7. Right, now we have, on this side, we have 18. 18 lies between the squares of which two numbers? 18 lies between 16 and 25, which is 4 square and 5 square. Now, we're going to take the smaller of the two numbers. So what are we going to do? We're going to take 4. Now, very easily, the answer to what is the square root of 1849 is either 43 or 47. We established that. Now, how do we zero in as to which one it is? 4 threes are 12, 4 sevens are 28. We are going to take the larger of the two, provided it is smaller than 18. The larger of the two is 28. It is not smaller than 18. So we need to pick 12. And therefore, the square root of 1849 is 43. Easy peasy. Now, trick number 5 is really not a trick, but a technique that I've always used to do this mental calculation of converting ratios to decimals to percentages. So what I have here is a number line. What is the number right in the middle? So let's say this is 0 and this is 1. Now, right in the middle, we have half. And you know that half is 50% and therefore it is 0.5. Easy. Now we know that this is 1/4. And you also know that 1/4 is 25% and therefore it is 0.25. So far so good. You're saying no difficulty. Here we have 3/4 and 3/4 is 75% and therefore it is 0.75. Now the fun begins when you start breaking this up further and further. Let's say your teacher says you need to divide something by 8. There you go. 1/8 of something. 1/8 of something is just half of 25. I don't need to divide 100 by 8. I just need to halve the 25. So I get 12.5% and therefore 0.125. Now, if you were to do, so this becomes automatically 2/8, right? So if you were to do 3/8, and do that for me in the comment section and tell me, if somebody told you to do, take a number and multiply it by 3/8, what are you going to find out here? Exactly between 25 and 50, you're going to find 37.5% and 0.375, and this is 3/8. Now, let's say you have to divide a number by 16 and leave a comment for me below and tell me what would you do when you had to divide a number by 16. So this becomes 1 upon 16. And what is 1 upon 16? Come on, tell me. Do you need to divide 100 by 16 to find it out? Or do you need to just divide 12 and a half by 2? And what do we get? So 1 upon 16 is 6.25%, and therefore 0.0625. Now, anything along 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, you can actually use this route to find out. Similarly, if you wanted to do 1/3, and I'm going to show that to you. Okay, here you go. You have 0 to 1 divided into 3 sections, and you have 1/3 and 2/3. Now you know that 1/3 is 33.3%, and you know that 2/3 is double of it, 66.67%, because it's a recurring 3. Now what if you had to find out 1/6? And quickly leave me a comment below and tell me what is 1/6. And in terms of decimals, what will that be? Yeah, so 1/6, all you have to do is do a half on 33. So 16.67%. And then it's very easy to convert these to decimals. So anything along 3, 6, and then if you had to further it, 1/12, all you have to do is take the number and start halving it instead of taking a big number and dividing it by 12. Okay, so here you are, 5 easy tricks to help you in your exams to get fast calculations. And by the way, we have 2 other videos in which we have math tricks as well. And I'm going to put a link for you in the description box below. And meantime, if you like this video, give me the thumbs up, press the subscribe button, and happy watching.